Hi, this is Ike from Groovy Entertainment. Today we got another book on tape to play for you. Today's book is The Story of the Pretender from 1988. So let's get started.
This is the golden story book and tape called The Story of the Pretenders. It was written by Cindy West, and the pictures were done by Hallmark Properties. Whenever you hear this sound, you'll know that it's time to turn the page. Now, open the book so our story can begin. Mr. Bungle's Piccadilly Pet Shop was a very exciting place. He had aardvarks and armadillos, and he even had elephants. He also had puppies, birds, bunnies, and a lot of cats. Customers came in day after day and bought the rare and beautiful animals. And they also bought the puppies, the birds, and the bunnies. But nobody bought the cats. Edgar, Mr. Bungle's pet dog, used to tease the cats constantly.
Nobody wants a homeless cat,
sneered Edgar.
Cats are as common as flies. Of course, if you were lucky enough to be an unusually fine dog like me, or a bird or a bunny, then maybe somebody might want you.
Said one of the liveliest cats.
I think Edgar's put his paw right on the problem. Why don't we disguise ourselves as other animals? And then I bet we would all find homes. What a great idea!
Said another cat as she plucked some feathers from a parrot when it wasn't looking.
I think I'll pretend to be a bird and call myself Chirper.
She chirped. The lively cat giggled as she hopped up and down.
I've always loved bunnies. I'll make some floppy ears and call myself Hopper.
In no time at all, the other cats joined in the fun. Scissors, paste, fur, and feathers were flying as disguises were being made. Two of the cats became a puppy and a duck, Romper and Flopper. And the cat who was as quiet as a mouse anyway became one and called herself Scamper. Edgar looked at them and laughed.
Nobody will ever fall for those disguises.
Said Scamper with a sigh.
Poor us,
groaned Romper, her puppy ears drooping.
Now, wait a minute,
said Hopper.
We'll never know if we don't try.
Hopper looked longingly out the window.
Hey,
she shouted.
Look at that. A truck is going to the county fair. If we follow it there, we'll find out if our disguises work. The fair is filled with animals.
Just then, Mr. Bungle had a sneezing attack.
I'm allergic to all those feathers,
he yelled. As he dashed out the door to get some medicine, all the pretenders dashed out behind him. Flopper was the first cat to leap onto the truck.
I hope there are ducks at the fair.
There'll be plenty of chickens,
said Romper, plopping down beside him.
I just love roosters,
Chirper said, laughing.
They're so very handsome. Somebody please help me up,
wailed Scamper. Hopper took a huge hop onto the truck and scooped up Scamper with a horse's feed bag. And the pretenders were off to the county fair. After a long ride, they finally was the first one off the truck. The other pretenders were very excited too, especially when their noses sniffed the air filled with the delicious aroma of hot dogs.
Where are the hot dogs?
Pitcher Purr asked.
I can smell them, but I can't see any. The hot dogs are way up there,
said Hot Purr.
Well, I know just how to get the hot dogs down here,
said Brown Purr. And she tickled the woman's legs with her whiskers. The lady began to giggle, and she giggled so much that she dropped her hot dog. The other pretenders tickled legs too, and soon hot dogs fell down by three. After the cats filled up on hot dogs, Chirper whistled for them to follow her.
Come on, everyone. The birds are in this tent. I can't wait to see the chickens.
Quack, 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 quack.
There weren't any chickens in the tent at all. But there were hundreds and hundreds of ducks. And who should be prancing around with them but Flopper?
What took you so long?
He asked.
I rushed right over to enter some contests.
Scamper noticed a sign that said, Pie Eating Contest.
Hey, that's for us,
said Romper and Flopper. But when they rushed inside the tent, the contest had already started. And Hopper was in it. She was gobbling away at carrot and rhubarb pie. The judges were very impressed with Hopper.
That bunny can really eat,
said one judge with a smile. Hopper ate as many pies as she could. But the winner was a freckled-faced boy who ate and ate and ate.
Guess we won't win any prizes,
complained Chirp Purr.
Hey, look,
shouted Round Purr.
At least we can get free pony rides. I've always wanted to ride a pony.
So all the pretenders jumped over the fence and leapt onto the ponies.
Ride on, cowboy,
called a man with a microphone as all the pretenders' ponies rushed out the gates and turned into bucking broncos.
And just look at that rabbit ride,
called a woman.
And that mouse,
shouted a fat man.
What an incredible sight.
I didn't know animals could ride,
said the school teacher.
You learn new things every day.
Tent of all. It was filled with children watching the most interesting pet contest.
I'm going to enter the dog contest,
said Romp Purr.
And I'll join those beautiful birds,
chirped Chirp Purr.
It's ducks for me,
brave Romp Purr bragged. Scamper and Hopper were too nervous to talk at all as they took their places with the mice and the bunnies. The judge looked over all the animals carefully.
This is the biggest, oldest mouse,
said the judge, and he hung a blue ribbon around Scamper's neck.
And this is certainly the funniest rabbit.
Then he gave Hopper a ribbon.
I've certainly never seen a cuter puppy than this,
he grinned when Romper nuzzled him and she accepted her prize.
As far as ducks go, I haven't heard this one quack once, so he's definitely the most unusual duck.
Flopper almost purred. He felt so happy.
And the last prize goes to this incredible parrot. I've never seen a parrot like this before.
Chirper squawked as loud as she could.
everybody laughed. The pretenders were very happy. Their disguises were perfect. Now they had to get back to the pet shop and put them to the final test to help them find new homes. Hopper was so excited, she hopped all the way back to Piccadilly. Flopper flopped his funny duck feet as Romper flopped beside him. And Chirper pounced overhead from tree to tree.
"Wait for me!"
cried Scamper as she scampered behind them all. Once back in the pet shop, each pretender hopped into the cage of the animal it was pretending to be.
"Ah," sneered Edgar, "your plan will never work."
But it did work. When the Piccadilly Pet Shop opened the next day, all attention was focused on the very unusual animals.
"Daddy, Daddy, can I have this bunny?"
asked the little girl.
"Sure," her dad said. "It looks like she really wants a home."
Hopper hopped up and down, wiggling her nose. The little girl took her new bunny and squeezed her tight.
"Oh, I love you so much. We'll have wonderful times together."
As she hugged the bunny, something very unusual happened. The bunny purred.
"What?"
she said, puzzled.
"Why, you're a cat."
"Yes, but don't tell anyone,"
Hopper pleaded.
"Oh, don't worry. I love you just the way you are. I'll keep your secret, I promise,"
said the little girl. And just as sure as cats purr, all the other pretenders found happy homes with children who loved them and kept their secrets, too.
So that was the story of the Pretenders from 1988. So if you like, subscribe, share, and comment, have a groovy day. And our next book will be Elf All Drops In.